So, how's your vision, or your night vision in particular? In this video, I'm going to talk about vitamin A, what it is, what it is not, and where you get it from, and where you don't get it from, because there is quite a lot of misleading marketing put out by the food industry. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew, I'm a nutritionist, and my vision is pretty good because I eat properly and I get the vitamin A that I need. Now, vitamin A is a chemical called retinol. And retinol plays a very important function in your immune system. It's important for the development of red blood cells, but its real function is to keep your eyes working correctly. Now, the cells in your eyes that are there to detect and respond to light, there are two types. There are two basic types. They're called rods and cones, funnily enough, because they are shaped like rods and cones. Okay, now the rods detect light at quite low levels and they tell you how strong the light is. The cones differentiate the light out into colors. So, for the cones to work and show you the colors, the light has to be a certain intensity. If the light is too low, the cones don't switch on, which is why you don't see colors when it's dark, even though you can actually see, because your rods are working, because your rods are picking up the starlight, the moonlight, the low levels of light when the sun isn't up, and it's enough for you to see, but you don't see colors because your cones haven't switched on. So there's your science geek trivia for the day. Now, without retinol or vitamin A, none of those cells would actually work properly and you wouldn't be able to see. So, one of the first signs of a deficiency in vitamin A is a deterioration in your ability to be able to see properly, and that shows up first in the rods that work in very low light. And so, you have what is sometimes called night blindness. The light is very low, and say, by the light of the moon, normally you would be able to see enough to move around, and now you can't really make anything out. Night blindness is the first sign of low vitamin A. Now, there are other symptoms. You have a very dry skin, but weirdly, if you have too much vitamin A, you also have very dry skin. So these other symptoms are not easy to track back to a vitamin A deficiency. Night blindness is. Where do you get vitamin A? Or retinol, okay, because that's what it really is. Retinol is found in animal products like liver, oily fish, cod liver oil, very good source of vitamin A, eggs, dairy, and fish. That is where you get retinol. Now, a lot of people will tell you that carrots, for example, are high in vitamin A. Oh, eat your carrots so that you can see at night. That is vaguely misleading because there is no vitamin A in a carrot. There is no retinol in a carrot. There is no retinol in anything that wasn't at some point a living animal. Okay, retinol is produced by animals, and that's why we have to eat cod liver oil, eggs, butter to get our retinol. What carrots have is something called a carotenoid, and in the carrot's case, it's a beta carotene. So you may have heard the word beta carotene. Beta carotene is not vitamin A. It's marketed as vitamin A because the food industry has been able to get the government in America to okay them calling it vitamin A. And why are they allowed to do that? Because yes, there is a process in your body that your liver can convert carotene into vitamin A. It's quite a complicated process. You need quite a lot of beta carotene to be able to make enough retinol, but it can be done. So you can manufacture retinol in your body if you eat enough beta carotene, but you would need a lot. So you really do actually need to get your vitamin A from a proper animal source. If you're a vegan and you're not going to eat eggs or butter or cod liver oil, and you're going to try and get all your vitamin A from carrots. Understand that carrots have quite a lot of sugar in them. So if you're on a keto, if you're a ketogenic type of vegan, you're gonna have difficulties. You probably need to be looking at getting some kind of retinol supplement, and there are plenty of them out there. The recommended daily allowance is something in the region of 3,000 to 4,000 international units or IUs. You can overdo that by double and it's not going to harm you, but vitamin A toxicity is a real thing. You can have too much vitamin A. Now, it's much more likely that you're going to be deficient in vitamin A and your night vision is not going to be good. If your night vision is fine, you probably have enough vitamin A, so you don't need to worry. But too much vitamin A can actually end up killing you. Okay, now don't panic. That's not going to happen to you. Okay, that used to happen from time to time to Arctic explorers 150 years ago who would shoot and kill polar bears and eat the meat and then eat the liver, and the liver of a polar bear is incredibly high in vitamin A and it would poison them and kill them. So don't eat a polar bear liver and you'll be fine. So there you have it. It's often used in countries in the third world where vitamin A is actually deficiency is actually a real problem. So in a lot of Africa, in India, the sort of Indian subcontinent, and even in parts of Indonesia where are chronically low levels of vitamin A amongst the lower income stratum of the population, and it is sometimes even used as a supplement as a matter of course in hospitals, and newborn babies are given a huge dose of vitamin A, anything up to 50,000 IUs. And remember I said your RDA is about 3,000 or 4,000 IUs, so they get a 10 times the daily dose, but as a one-off dose. It does accumulate in your body. It's a fat-soluble vitamin, so it's not something you have to take every day, but you do have to take it on a regular basis just to keep your levels up. Anyway, like I said, your night vision will not be good if you don't take vitamin A. Don't believe the nonsense about carrots having vitamin A in them. They don't. They have a chemical in them that can be used in your body to create vitamin A, but it's not vitamin A. Vitamin A is retinol, and I hope you see that now. Ha ha, jeez, that is so weak. Okay, I'm not going to try and be funny. Thank you for your time. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of our content.